So, welcome to this class of artificial intelligence where we are discussing fuzzy logic. And now we will discuss an example through which we will understand fuzzy inference mechanism. So, for this example, we will take an inverted pendulum which is to be controlled. This is an inverted pendulum which is going to rotate on this hinge here. It is hinged here and its movement can be in this direction, angular movement, and in this direction it can have angular movement, and we can push in either of these directions, and this push or pull is governed through a motor here which needs current for its operation. So that current, if it is positive, then it will cause movement in this direction, and if current is negative, then it will cause movement in this direction. Now we will see that what are the inputs in this case. So inputs are error, which we will be representing in, which is a difference, in radian, and this difference in radian is with respect to this perpendicular position. So if this pendulum comes here, then this angle which is formed is error. Second input is omega, which is angular velocity. These two inputs are there, and then we have one output which is current. So output is current, and this will be plus or minus or direction as discussed. Now we will see the fuzzification. So for fuzzification, we will require membership functions for all these, for error, for omega, and for current. Current would be required in defuzzification. But for fuzzification process, error and omega would be required. So let us assume that this error is having membership function like this, that when error is 0, then its membership function is 1, and if it goes up to minus 15 degrees centigrade to plus 15 degrees centigrade, not centigrade, degrees, this angle, not temperature. So this is the plot when we are membership function, when we say that error is 0. Means if we are getting some angle here, then also this is having membership, some membership value between 0 and 1. 1 is here, 0 is here, some value between 0 and 1. Membership value in this fuzzy set of error. Similarly, another error fuzzy term is there, which we call positive small. This positive small fuzzy set gives membership value 1 when temperature is not temperature. This error in angle is plus 15 degrees. So other values around plus 15 degrees will be having some membership in this fuzzy set. Then comes a third fuzzy term, which we call positive medium, and its membership function will be like this. Similarly, we will have membership function for another term, which we call positive small. It will not be positive small, negative small. And this membership function we will call negative medium. Here it will go up to minus 30 degrees centigrade, not centigrade, I am sorry, minus 30 degrees, and this is plus 30 degrees. Similarly, the other input, which is omega, or this also we can plot the fuzzy membership functions, and here we assume that variation of this is going to be from minus 10 degree per second to plus 10 degree per second, and the same terms positive medium, positive small, zero are assigned to this also. So here we have 0 degree per second omega, which is angular velocity, and the membership function for 0 angular velocity is like this. Membership function for negative small angular velocity is this, and angular velocity having positive term negative medium is like this. Similarly, positive small and positive medium angular velocities omegas are having their corresponding fuzzy function, membership function like this. This will be going from this to this. Here it is plus 5 degree per second and plus minus 5 degree per second. Then for current also we have membership function, which is output quantity here, this one, and membership values vary from 0 to 1, and we are having the same labels: 0, negative small, negative medium, positive small, positive medium. So this also is having, suppose here it is 0 milliampere, then 5 milliampere, and this point is suppose 10 milliampere, and here it is minus 5 milliampere, and this point is suppose 10 milliampere. This is minus 10 milliampere. So membership functions will be for 0 current like this: 0, negative small, negative medium, positive small, it should be, triangles are not correctly drawn, this is positive small, and from here to here it is negative small. Then comes the rules. So for that inverted pendulum, there is someone in that lab who has some experience with that, And based on his experience, that fellow or that engineer or that researcher says, gives us a table of rules of error and omega. These are inputs. And then the currents he has observed. And he says that if error is zero and omega is zero, then current is zero. This is very simple. When there is no error in the pendulum, this error or difference in radian is zero, means this pendulum is perpendicular. Then we need not move this cart either on the right or on the left. And yes, of course, omega, angular velocity, is also not there in this pendulum. So there is no control action required, no movement on either right or left is required. Then that engineer says that if error is zero and omega is positive small, then current will be negative small. Now, what does it mean? This means that this omega, which we have here, if it is negative medium, so negative medium means this error is zero, means its difference in radian is zero, but there is angular velocity, and that angular velocity is negative medium, this one, means minus 10 degrees per second is going to be there. So in that case, our current should be positive small here. So positive small current moves this in this direction, in this direction. So it means that when it was going to fall in this direction, it was going to fall in this direction, in this one, then it is going to move in this direction so that this pendulum can be made vertical. It's an effort is done by the cart. Then another rule is given by the engineer that says that if error is zero and omega is negative medium, then current is positive small. Then here you can see that is when it was positive small, then current was negative small. So obviously when it will be in negative side, negative medium, then it will be in positive side, positive small. So one thing is clear, then when it is positive, then it's going to be negative, and when it is negative, then it will be positive. But here we have slight difference, which is based on experience, that when it is positive small, means we have small, then here also it is small. But when it is on negative side and with medium, then we have small. It's not going to be medium corresponding to medium. Here we don't have medium. Then fourth rule, he says that if error is positive medium and omega is z, then current is going to be negative small, negative medium. So this means that here error we have, some error which is positive medium, means it's going to be have some angle, and along with that angle there is no omega associated, means there is no angular velocity. Then it should be negative medium, means minus current, and it should move in this direction so that it can be adjusted. So not in this direction, rather, if error is going to be positive medium, means error is in this direction, and then cart moves in this direction to balance, to make this move on this side and become vertical. So we have seen that the engineer has given these four rules, not more than this, but can you tell that how many rules are possible? So if you see here, then you can see that if we take error one case, suppose negative medium, and we are forming rules, then if error is negative medium and omega is negative medium, then current is negative medium, something like this. These are, I am exploring possible rules. Similarly, for error negative medium, omega negative small, then error negative medium, omega zero, error negative medium, omega positive small, this negative medium, positive medium. In this way, for error nm, we can have five rules. Similarly, for this also, we can have all these five rules, five omegas. In this way, if we take all these five options and all these five options, then it will be 5 into 5 and corresponding currents. If we take all these five, then our number of rules will be 5 into 5, possible rules into 5 is equal to 5 cube. But here comes the role of experience. So engineer has seen that only these four rules are enough, and sometimes all the rules are it's not necessary. Most of the rules, you form the rules, you will find that they are redundant. Theoretically you can form rules, but practically they have no significance. So that's why the rules of significance are going to be less in number, and of high significance are also going to be further less. Now I am given inputs, and the inputs are that error is equal to 27 degrees and omega is equal to minus 1.5 degree per second. Under this situation, what should be the current? Now this is really a control problem. Here you won't see any fuzziness. Then it's obvious that as per the discussed fuzzy inference system, we need to fuzzify this. So to fuzzify, what we need to do is that we take help of those membership functions like this error and this error and the rules which have been given to us. Now if you look at this 27 degrees, error of 27 degrees, you can see that in this error fuzzy membership functions, you will find that 27 degrees comes here. So we will take only these two fuzzy membership functions corresponding to PS and PM. And this value will only fall in these two and it will not fall in all others. So what we can do is that we can plot this power error, and this will be like this. Here it is. It is 27 degrees. So we have this plus 30 degrees. Here we have 15 degrees, plus 15 degrees, this is positive medium, and corresponding to positive small, we have this membership function which goes up to 0 degrees, and this 27 is coming here, somewhat here suppose, here it is 27 degrees, and this is going to correspond to 0.8 membership value of membership in this fuzzy set, and membership in this positive small is going to be this value. And you know that we are talking about error, and you can see here that in case of error, we have only two cases, positive medium and zeros. There are no rules here no rules, which are going to talk about positive small in case of error. You can see here, all zeros and positive. So we will not be taking this case. This will be covered in any other rule, but not in this rule which are given here. Similarly, if we take the fuzzy membership functions corresponding to omega, which is given here. So here we see that it is 0 degree per second, and its membership plot is going to be like this. And here it is, can refer here, it's minus 5 degree per second. So this comes out to be minus 5 degree per second, and 1.5 will be somewhere here. So this is minus 1.5 degrees per second, and we know that this is corresponding to zero. So this omega we have plotted here. So this omega 1.5 will be here. This is what we are looking at, and this corresponds to angular velocity. So zero angular velocity is having fuzzy membership function like this. So it covers angular velocity up to minus 5 degree per second to plus 5 degree per second. So a value here falls under this triangle and has membership value. Suppose this value comes out to be 0.7, and there is another rule, another membership function corresponding to this term, which is negative small. But we need to explore here that do we have negative small for this term omega in this rule. So as in this rule there is no negative small is not coming, so whatever value we are getting here in negative small, which is this, is there but will be referred in any other rule. In our rules it is not coming. Now we need to see that which rule will be applicable here. So we see that positive medium error, when it is in positive medium, then membership value of this 27 degrees error is going to be 0.8, which comes under positive medium. So we need to look for this value, positive medium, for error. So this is positive medium, and here it is 0. So this 0 is there. So this rule is getting applicable for these values which are given here when we explore on these two fuzzy membership functions. So this rule suggests that the current should be negative medium. So we will draw the current membership function, and negative medium will be this minus 10 milliampere to minus 5 milliampere. Here this is going to be, this is negative medium. Now this rule says that if we need to write down that rule. So this is the rule: if error is positive medium, this one, if error is positive medium and omega is z, 0, then current is negative medium, current is negative medium. Now this AND operation is to be done. We have got two values, 0.7 and 0.8. So here this AND suggests that and is equal to minimum of, it is as we have seen earlier that it is operated with the help of min. So minimum of these two, 0.7 and 0.3. So minimum of 0.7 and 0.8, which comes out to be 0.7. So we will take on this current fuzzy membership function value corresponding to 0.7 due to this AND operation, and corresponding to this 0.7 we will draw a straight line, and only NM is this rule is being used. So this suggests that only this fuzzy membership function will be used here. Now what is the answer as per the fuzzy inference system? This area is the answer. This area is the answer when we are using our fuzzy inference system. This is our fuzzy answer. In this block diagram here, the output which we are getting, this output which we are getting is this area. This area. Now we need to do defuzzification. So there are many methods for defuzzification. One of them is center of gravity. So we can take center of gravity of this area, and that one, suppose that center of gravity is here, and this tells us this value on the x-axis, and this value is suppose minus not zero, minus 6.2 milliampere. You can exactly calculate it. So this is going to be our answer, which is to be substituted here, minus 6.2 milliampere. Now, as far as these rules are concerned, these many rules are given, but only one rule worked here. It means that this rule got fired. We use the term firing of the rule. Firing of the rule. Other rules which were not applicable, they did not fire. This rule did not fire. This rule did not fire. And how did we know this? We knew by the values given here. So when these values were given and we were supposed to do this fuzzification, then we saw that in which part of the membership function they fall. And depending on that, wherever they fall, we explore the rule base and find out that which rule is to be fired. And then using these values of membership from the membership function, we operated using and got the value. And corresponding to that membership value, we get an area, and then using defuzzification methods, we get one exact scalar value, which is this. So this is an example that how to use fuzzy inference mechanism. So I close here. Thank you.